Hello friends, markets have been extremely volatile over the past month due to the uncertainty created by the coronavirus. We have seen a sharp fall in equity markets both globally and in India. For example, in the US, the S&P 500 has fallen more than 35% from its recent peak, and even in India, the Nifty has fallen close to 35%. Now, one of the reasons for the sharp fall in the markets has been the high intensity FII selling. And they have sold more than $7 billion over the past 2 weeks. A large part of the selling may not be related to fundamental reasons, but because of unwinding by quant funds and hedge funds which were leveraged, as well as outflows from some of the global ETFs. Now the question is, in this volatile environment, how should investors tackle this environment and how should they think about their portfolio allocation? So there are three important things to consider. One is the impact of the virus on global economic growth. Second is how it translates into earnings growth. And the third is valuations. So let's look at each of them one by one. Now we have seen that countries like China, Korea, Taiwan and Hong Kong have seemingly managed to control or contain the virus. However, it is spreading globally. And while efforts are on to contain it in Europe, US as well as in India, we have yet to see a peak in the number of new cases. And we are seeing new cases coming out almost every day. So at this time, it looks like the impact of the virus may be there for the next few months or maybe a couple of quarters. Because of this, global economic growth has been downgraded to less than 1% from the earlier 3% estimate. And even for India, the FY21 GDP growth has been downgraded to below 4% to below 5% from the earlier 6%. And there are risks of further downgrades till we see a peak in the number of new cases of the virus. Now on the positive front, globally, governments as well as central banks are working closely to try and support their economies. For example, in the US, we have seen the Fed reducing its policy rate to almost zero, announcing a $750 billion bond buying program, and even the government is evaluating a $1 trillion plus fiscal stimulus. In Europe, the ECB has announced a 750 billion euro bond buying program. In India, the RBI has yet to reduce rates, but it has announced a variety of measures to enhance the liquidity in the system. And the expectation is that this coordinated policy action should help to revive the global growth in the second half of this calendar year and help to support equity markets. In terms of earnings growth, different sectors will be impacted to different extent because of the virus. Some sectors will be negatively impacted, while some sectors may see some positive benefits. For example, sectors like IT and metals, which are exposed to global macros, are seeing some pressure on the demand front, but they will also be benefited because of the rupee depreciation. Secondly, service-oriented sectors like apparel and retail, travel and tourism, or restaurants, consumer durables, and even high-ticket discretionary items like autos are being impacted by the containment efforts within India, because of which people are increasingly being asked to stay at home. Thirdly, credit costs are tightening and banks may see some increase in the NPAs. And as banks were thought to be one of the major drivers of FY21 earnings, this will have a significant impact on the earnings growth for the next fiscal year. On the positive side, sectors such as consumer staples and pharma are seeing a surge in demand. And because oil prices have crashed to below $25 a barrel, oil marketing companies are also seeing some benefits. Now, regarding valuations, equity markets seem to have entered the attractive zone on a variety of metrics. On a price-to-book multiple on a trading basis, the number now stands at 1.9 times, which is what was seen earlier during the 2008 global financial crisis, as well as in 2011. The trading PE multiple for the Nifty is also at its long-term average of around 16 to 17 times. The yield gap, which is the difference between the earnings yield for the Nifty and the 10-year G-Sec yield, also indicates that equities are in an attractive zone. The market cap to GDP ratio for India is coming close to levels of 55%, which was last seen during the global financial crisis in 2008. We believe that equities are in an attractive zone currently. So now coming to the question, how should investors think about their portfolio allocation? Like I said, it is not being expected that the impact of the virus may be felt for the next few months or at least for a couple of quarters. And that will impact the GDP growth to some extent as well as the earnings growth. We expect that the FY21 Nifty earnings growth will be downgraded by about 10% from the earlier 23% to 13 to 15% right now, with the risk of further downgrades going forward. And as I mentioned, valuations are attractive. So this is an ideal time for investors to increase the equity exposure, even though it is not clear at this point whether we have reached the bottom in the equity markets. So for investors who already have a balanced allocation to both large caps, mid caps and small caps in their portfolio, they should continue with that allocation while increasing the overall equity exposure. Investors who have some cash can allocate it more to large caps than to say mid and small caps. And investors who are coming in afresh would be advised to stick more to the large caps and over time build up their positions in mid caps and small caps. I hope this was helpful. Thank you.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.